Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today in this video I am going to show you how to use Visual Studio Code for Java programming. So if you want to be a Java developer, then Visual Studio is a very good, you know, platform where you can, you know, code, you can debug, you can create any Java projects. So in this video I am going to show you in detail how to use Visual Studio Code for Java. So for that, first you need to go to your favorite browser and you need to just simply search Visual Studio Code for Java and hit enter, and this will show you this Java in Visual Studio Code. So if you just simply open that, you'll get a complete, you know, tutorial and complete guidance on how to use Java. So this is, you know, they have a very good documentation, so this is all about that. So in this video I'm going to, you know, talk about it, so you can watch this video itself, and if you need more information you can always refer to this article. So from here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to, you know, click on this install the coding pack for Java. So it's going to start downloading our file. So this file will get downloaded. So once it get downloaded, what we are going to do is we are going to just simply click on this exe over here. So if you are using Windows 11, you might see this type of pop-up that the app that you are trying to install isn't a Microsoft verified app, which is totally fine. Just, you know, simply click on install anyway. Okay, and you can minimize your browser. And here you can see this installed coding pack for Java installation wizard is rightly open. So this license agreement is already checked. All you need to do is you need to just simply click on next over here. And it's going to start, you know, configuring the component. So it will need a couple of software. One is Java Development Kit. So it's going to install JDK. Okay. And here the text editor that we are going to use is Visual Studio Code. Okay. So everything is fine. Click on install and it's going to start installing our JDK. So the thing is, you need to have active internet connection. As you can see, it is fetching all the files from internet and it's going to install it locally on your system. So you need to have active internet connection right throughout this installation. You can see our JDK is downloaded and it is, you know, preparing to install. And you can see that our JDK is installed properly. But here it is telling that it's failed to download Visual Studio Code. So this is, you know, a common bug, you can say. I have also observed this. So what you can do is you can install manually. So that button is also they have provided. So just simply click on this button and it's going to redirect to the Visual Studio official site. So here you can see it is rightly redirected. So from here you need to click on this download button and it's going to download our IDE. So our Java is installed, Java JDK. Only the IDE part is there, the software is actually failing for some reason, which is fine. We can install it manually also, no big deal. So here you can see we have successfully downloaded our Visual Studio Code. So you need to just simply click on that exe. And again, this pop-up came. So you need to just simply click on install anyway. And you can minimize our browser. Just simply accept this license agreement. Click on next. Click on next. Click on next. You know, check these checkboxes. Click on next. And click on install. And it's going to install it. Okay. And this you can close now. Okay, so let this get finished. I'll be again back to this video. So welcome back, and now you can clearly see that our Visual Studio is rightly installed. Desktop shortcut is also created, so you can just simply, you know, enable this launch Visual Studio Code, click on finish, and it's going to open our Visual Studio. And you can see that our Visual Studio is rightly opened over here. So now that you know that our both Java JDK is installed along with Visual Studio Code, it's time to code first. Okay, so for that what you need to do is you need to click on this explorer and click on open folder, and let's create a folder in our document directory. I'll name this folder as java_practice, and I'm going to select this folder, and you'll be able to see that our folder is rightly opened over here. Yes, I trust the authors. Right, so our folder is rightly open. Let's create a new file. So click on this and just simply give a new file name that like hello.java and hit enter, and you'll be able to see that it is rightly opened. And here also you can see a pop-up is coming that whether do you like to install this extension pack for Java. So it is highly recommend to install this. So that is what I'm going to also show. So you can go to this extension and you need to just simply search over here Java. So once you search that, you'll be able to see this, you know, extension pack for Java. So it is highly recommend to install this. I'll click on this install button and it's going to install all these plugins. So it includes debugger for Java, test runner for Java. So it's going to, you know, create a beautiful run button right over here, right? Then project manager for Java, then Maven for Java. Along with that, it also going to install this language support for Java by Red Hat, right? So let's wait for a couple of minutes. So we'll come back once again. So now you can see that all our plugins are actually installed. You can see everything is installed now. So you can just simply close this and you can go back to our Java project that we have created, the Java practice folder and hello.java file that we have created. So here you can just simply type class and immediately you can see one template over here coming, right? So all you need to do is you need to just simply hit enter. Once you hit enter, you can see automatically that template came like public class hello. Now the next thing that we need to do is you need to create a public static void main. So again, as soon as you type, you can see the template coming. So you need to, you know, go to click on that, press that down key and again hit enter. Immediately you can see, you know, it is rightly created our main method. So now we'll just simply type system.out.println. Again, we'll use IntelliSense and we'll just simply print over here hello world, right? And as I have told, once you have all plugin installed, you'll be able to see this run button. So you need to click on this run button and it's going to start compiling our Java. So this, if this pop-up comes, you need to just simply click on allow. This is just a Windows security thing, you need to give allow, right? And here you can see the output coming hello world. So in this way you can easily use Visual Studio Code for, you know, writing your Java code snippet. So I have shown you about the extensions and also I have shown you how you can easily run it by just simply clicking of a button, right? So in my next video I'm going to talk about how you can easily debug any Java program. So sometimes what happens is a program could be quite huge, like it could have been like thousands of lines of code. So it is very difficult to, you know, maintain that sort of code or to debug or to find any errors, or let's say you want to introduce any new functionality over there. So that time it is very important to debug the code, right? So if you use Visual Studio Code, this Visual Studio Code will give you that that functionality to debug. You can see this link is also coming over here, right? So in my next video I'm going to talk about how you can debug, you know, Java program. So for that you need to subscribe your channel, you need to hit like button. If you are liking this video, then you need to comment in our comment sections. That really helps me to motivate and make more such videos. I also started a Geeky Syntax channel, so if you're interested you can always subscribe this channel. So here I post you know, coding related videos, so coding and programming. So if you're interested, I'll highly recommend you to subscribe this channel. I have just newly started. Once I get significant amount of subscriber, I'll going to regularly post coding related videos over here. So please do, you know, subscribe this channel as well if you're interested. And I have also started a vlogging channel. So recently I was in Kashmir, so I just posted one beautiful video about Dal Lake. So again, if you're interested, you can also, you know, subscribe our Geeky Script vlogging channel, right? So yeah, thank you very much for watching this video. Please do like, share and subscribe. That will really help me to make more such videos. So thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.